Greetings, everyone, and welcome once again to the Baptist Bread and Scripture Song broadcast for this 22nd day of April, 2024. It is Monday, and today's topic is titled, The Earnest of Our Inheritance. And before we get started on all that, I'd like to greet you as always, in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, who is the Lamb of God, which taketh away the sin of the world. And he too can be your Lord and Savior today, if he's not already. And you need to put your faith and trust in Jesus Christ alone. Nothing else can save your soul. Water baptism can't save you. It just gets you wet. And plus, it's an outward appearance showing after you get saved to other believers that you've been saved and crucified and dead and then made alive with Christ in heavenly places. And so you got to understand that and study that out and make sure you know that it's only by God's way. And if there was any other way, then Jesus Christ wouldn't have had to come down here and die for our sins. And even he himself begged to God the Father to take that cup away from him. But then he said, not my will, but thine be done. So that's the only way to trust in Jesus Christ and have your sins washed away and believe on him. And then after you get saved, then he will show you and guide you, direct you in all truth and help you to be a good follower of his and a good Christian and believer and all that. So, and you get in a good Bible-believing church and read the word and rightly divide the word and all that stuff. So, okay. So I hope that this broadcast is a help and blessing, encouragement, and edifying you in some way. That's why I do these devotionals, and none of this is my material. I try to put my own spin on it and add to it as I see fit that to teach you more as I have learned myself. So, but this is all God's word and been studied out by these men that write these devotionals, and so, and to help you get a little bit of a further understanding, and then you can look on these things on your own time further. So, all right, so let's go ahead and get into the scripture song first for today from Isaiah 43 verse 7. And let's go ahead and look at Isaiah 43 really quick. And of course we need to understand that the Old Testament is written to the Jews, but of course we can take things from the Old Testament and apply it to our lives spiritually and practically as believers. And need to know who God is talking to and writing to in these chapters here, so you don't wrongly divide the word of truth and wrest the scriptures to destruction and all that. So, and make up crazy doctrines like so many people do. So here we go, chapter 43, and there is 28 verses here. So we will go ahead and let's see here, Isaiah 43, and let's see, verse 7 is the scripture song verse, and we will go ahead and read up to verse 7, and then you can read the rest of the chapter on your own time, unless we need to read the whole entirety. We'll see how far we get. So this is chapter 43 of Isaiah, and it says here in verse 1, but now, thus saith the Lord that created thee, O Jacob, and he that formed thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name. Thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee. For I am the Lord thy God, the Holy One of Israel, thy Savior. I gave Egypt for thy ransom, Ethiopia and Seba for thee, since thou wast precious in my sight, he says, the Lord says here, and, since thou wast precious in my sight, thou hast been honorable, and I have loved thee. Therefore will I give men for thee, and people for thy life. Fear not, for I am with thee. I will bring thy seed from the east, and gather thee from the west. I will say to the north, give up, and to the south, keep not back. Bring my sons from far, and my daughters even from the ends of the earth, even every one that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Hallelujah. So, and that's a scripture song today, so you understand the context here. And then it continues on in verse 8 with a new paragraph and goes all the way to verse 28, so you can get the rest of that on your own time. And now let's go ahead and sing the scripture song here. And this is one of my favorites because I like how he will start off and he gets a little faster and faster. So this is a little bit of a fun one. So here we go. Let's go ahead and sing along with Brother Dean and Sister Patty.
Isaiah 43:7.
Even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I made him. Even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name. Amen. All right. So, there you have it. That's what I was talking about, how he gets faster and faster. And towards the end. All right. And then in the middle of the page here, this is what it looks like there. I know it's backwards on the screen, but that's the Bible there. And it says, the Bible will keep you from sin, or sin will keep you from the Bible. And that's the truth. So, we'll do those scripture songs again towards the end of the broadcast, but now it's time to get into today's Baptist Bread topic for this 22nd day of April, and it's titled, again, the Earnest of Our Inheritance. And we have here Ephesians 1:14 says, which is the earnest of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession unto the praise of his glory. And that's Ephesians 1:14. And today's author is B.H. That would be the initials for B.H. That's Buddy Howard, and he's the pastor of Calvary Baptist Church in Jennings, L.A. And so let's go ahead and look at Ephesians chapter 1 really quick before we get into the topic. So Ephesians chapter 1, and Ephesians, book of Ephesians is a good book to read also. And so let's see here. There's 23 verses. So let's go ahead and we'll read the entirety of this chapter here. And this is here the epistle of Paul the Apostle to the Ephesians, chapter 1. Paul, an apostle of Jesus Christ by the will of God, to the saints which are at Ephesus, and to the faithful in Christ Jesus. Grace be to you, and peace from God our Father, and from the Lord Jesus Christ. And Brother James has a good series of messages on the book of Ephesians from way back in 2011, and he had this this topic here about how we're all saints, but not all of us are faithful in Christ Jesus. So we're all saved and made saints, but there's only so many that tend to want to be faithful in Christ Jesus. So hopefully you're one of those that will want to do that and all that. So I encourage you to go check out that series of messages there by Brother James. You can go on the church website, which I'll give you at the end of the broadcast, and look up that those series of messages and this particular one I'm talking about. So continuing on in verse 3, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who hath blessed us with all spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ, according as he hath chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Jesus Christ to himself, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of the glory of his grace, wherein he hath made us accepted in the Beloved, in whom we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins, according to the riches of his grace, wherein he hath abounded toward us in all wisdom and prudence, having made known unto us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure, which he hath purposed in himself that in the dispensation of the fullness of times he might gather together in one all things in Christ, both which are in heaven and which are on earth, even in him, in whom also we have obtained an inheritance, being predestinated according to the purpose of him who worketh all things after the counsel of his own will, that we should be to the praise of his glory, who first trusted in Christ, in whom ye also trusted, after that ye heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, in whom also, after that ye believed, ye were sealed with that Holy Spirit of promise, which is the earnest of our inheritance, until the redemption of the purchased possession, unto the praise of his glory. Wherefore I also, after I heard of your faith in the Lord Jesus and love unto all the saints, cease not to give thanks for you, making mention of you in my prayers, that the God of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of glory, may give unto you the spirit of wisdom and revelation in the knowledge of him, the eyes of your understanding being enlightened, that ye may know what is the hope of his calling, and what the riches of the glory of his inheritance in the saints, and what is the exceeding greatness of his power to usward, who believe according to the working of his mighty power, which he wrought in Christ when he raised him from the dead, and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places, far above all principalities and power, all principality and power, and might and dominion, and every name that is named not only in this world, but also in that which is to come, and hath put all things under his feet, and gave him to be the head over all things to the church, which is his body, the fullness of him that filleth all in all. Hallelujah. So if you're saved, born again believer in Christ, you're part of the body of Christ, the church, born again believer. So that's the entirety of the chapter there. And now here we go. Title here is The Earnest of Our Inheritance. And we read the whole chapter, including the verse here for today. And again, Ephesians 1:14 says, which is the earnest of our inheritance until the redemption of the purchased possession unto the praise of his glory. And Brother Buddy writes here, he goes, oh, what enlightenment, what joys, what consolation, what delight of heart is experienced by those of us who have learned to feed on Jesus and on him alone. Amen. Yet the realization which we have of Christ's preciousness is in this life imperfect at best. As an old writer said, 'tis but a taste. And so it says, come and taste and see that the Lord is good and all that. We have tasted that the Lord is gracious, right? We've tasted that the Lord is gracious, but we do not know how good and gracious he is, although what we know of his sweetness makes us long for more. That's right, and hopefully makes you long for more. We have enjoyed the first fruits of the Spirit, and they have set us hungering and thirsting for the fullness of heaven's home. We groan within ourselves, waiting for the adoption. We are but beginners now in spiritual education, right? So always growing, always learning. For although we have learned the first letters of the alphabet of grace, we cannot read all the words yet, much less can we put sentences together. We have many ungratified desires at present, but soon every dream shall be satisfied, and all our power will be, and all our power will know the sweetness in that world of joy. Within a very little while, we shall be rid of all our trials and troubles, right? That'd be a glorious day. We're up there with Jesus. Our eyes, now filled with tears, shall weep no longer. The triumph of his glory shall be shared by us. His crown, his joy, his paradise, these shall be ours, and we will be co-heirs with him. Jesus Christ, the heir of all things, hallelujahs, shall reign like summers pleasant showers through all eternity. Amen. So, looking for that blessed hope, Jesus Christ and his glorious appearing and all that, and waiting for the rapture, or if you die first and go up to be with Jesus that way, that'll be a glorious day there, and no more pain and sorrow and all that. But in the meantime, we got to keep on pressing on, pressing towards that mark, and keep on fighting the battles and stuff of this world and the devil and the flesh and all that, and get the victory, as Brother Altop was preaching on during the youth rally. So if you missed any of those messages, I encourage you to go back and listen to those, or if you need to be having that stuff again, go back and listen to it again. Amen. So nothing wrong with getting edified again and hearing it again. So, all right, because you might have missed something. All right, so that's the Baptist bread for today. Good topic there about our inheritance and all that. So now let's go ahead and get into the Daily Strength Volume 2 book. And this is written by Douglas D. Stauffer and Andrew B. Ray. And today is day 79, Monday. And we are going into this topic on fasting. And we started on it yesterday with all the introductory stuff here. And so day 79, Monday, is titled, What is Fasting? And we have here Acts 27:33 says, And while the day was coming on, Paul besought them all to take meat, saying, This day is the 14th day that ye have tarried and continued fasting, having taken nothing. So, all right, so that was the passage there, and that was in, they were on the ship, in Euroclydon, I think it was Euroclydon, and the storm happened, and they were all fearful, and they didn't listen to Paul. They listened to the captain instead, and should have listened to Paul, and he told them not to fear, and they were fasting to try to get God to calm the storm and stuff. And then Paul told them that they didn't have to worry about fasting anymore, that they can eat and all that. So I encourage you to read all of Acts 27 to get the entirety of the account there. So now let's go ahead and read the introductory thoughts. It says, Modern Christianity has been redefining Bible terminology, and fasting is no exception. Perhaps this is because Christians want to look spiritual without the necessary dedication. Some claim to be fasting from certain things like caffeine or sugar intake, right? The Bible does not offer anyone this type of latitude. True biblical fasting involves much more than refraining from some hand-picked pleasure. According to our passage, Paul entreated the people to take meat because they had been fasting for 2 weeks. Esther 4:16 reveals that fasting consists of taking no food or drink. Although some Bible teachers have suggested that fasting means to simply refrain from earthly joys, fasting in the Bible always includes refraining from food or from both food and drink. Even the results of fasting identify that it is associated with depriving the body of food, right? In Psalm 109, verse 24, David said, My knees are weak through fasting, and my flesh faileth of fatness. Foregoing earthly pleasures is a byproduct of fasting, not the sole object. Yeah, so there you have the introductory thoughts. So that's what fasting is. And now a devotional thoughts for children. It says, read Matthew 15:32. So let's go there and read Matthew 15:32. And we might need to get some context here. So Matthew 15. And let's go here, verse 32. Let's see here. All right, so 32 starts a new paragraph. And we'll go ahead and read it down through the rest of the chapter, verse 32 through 39, to get the context here of what is happening. So in verse 32, it says, Then Jesus called his disciples unto him and said, I have compassion on the multitude, because they continue with me now 3 days and have nothing to eat, and I will not send them away fasting, lest they faint in the way. And his disciples say unto him, Whence should we have so much bread in the wilderness as to fill so great a multitude? And Jesus saith unto them, How many loaves have ye? And they said, Seven, and a few little fishes. And he commanded the multitude to sit down on the ground. And he took the 7 loaves and the fishes, and gave thanks, and brake them, and gave to his disciples, and the disciples to the multitude. And they did all eat, and were filled. And they took up of the broken meat that was left 7 baskets full. And they that did eat were 4,000 men, beside women and children. And he sent away the multitude, and took ship, and came into the coast of Magdala. So that's where he was feeding the multitude there. And so that was that. We read that. And it says here, Jesus called going without food fasting. Fasting can also mean going without food and water. And that's Exodus 34:28 is the reference. And that can apply to all of us, not just children. And now for everyone. It says, when is the last time you purposely refused to eat or drink anything for the purpose of bringing glory to God? What was the reason for which you fasted? And hopefully it's something that you were desiring for someone else, like maybe praying for someone's health, that the Lord would heal them in some way, or something like that, or a loved one, and their walk with the Lord. So, and getting serious about asking God to help that person. So, all right, and it says, so what was the reason for which you fasted? And then it says, have you ever fasted? If not, why? So, if you don't, if you've never fasted, try it, and you'll see how much the flesh craves food and all that stuff, and how difficult it can be when you're fasting and not going without food or drink. And so it says, have you ever fasted? If not, why? Do you think the Lord mentions fasting without purpose, or do you think he truly desires for his people to fast? Of course, we know it's not a commandment, but of course, he always recommends it, and we should do it, especially if we're serious about something certain that we want, or we want for someone else, or whatever. So, all right, so that was devotional thoughts. Now for prayer thoughts. It says, ask the Lord to give you the courage to fast for him. And then it says, ask God to teach you the benefits of fasting. So, and then the hymn from the book today is titled, From Every Earthly Pleasure. And so we're going to do that one first. And could not find a full instrumental for that one, but found a sampling. So we'll listen to it really quick, and then we'll try to sing along with it. And then we'll move on to the second hymn. And couldn't find an instrumental for that one, but what I'm going to do with that one is I'll read you all the stanzas, and then I'll let you listen to this group of men that sang it. And I don't think they sang the whole entirety of it, but you get to understand the words here, and it's a good song. I was listening to it, and I liked it, so maybe you'll like it. So, all right, so this first one we're going to do is from page 549 in the hymn book. And this is one of these Aspiration of the Saint hymns, a spiritual song, titled From Every Earthly Pleasure, written by Eliel Davis. That's E-L-I-E-L, Eliel Davis, 1803 to 1849. And then traditional Moravian melody from the Swedish Hemmets, Korolbok. That's K-O-R. A-L-B-O-K, Korolbok, 1921. So, and there is a little story at the bottom here. So let's press play and listen to it first. Here we go. Thank you. It doesn't sound too challenging. Here you go. From every earthly pleasure, from every transient joy, from every mortal treasure that soon will fade and die. No longer these desiring upwards our wishes tend, to nobler bliss aspiring, and joys that never end. From every piercing sorrow that heaves our breast today, or threatens us tomorrow, hope turns our eyes away. On wings of faith ascending, we see the land of light and feel our sorrows ending in infinite delight. 'Tis true we are but strangers and sojourners below, and countless snares and dangers surround the path we go. Though painful and distressing, yet there's a rest above, and onward still we're pressing to reach that land of love. Amen. All right, so that was the hymn. And now let me read you this little story here at the bottom. It says, at 19, Davis moved to London, joining with a local congregation of which Joseph Ivamy was pastor in his native town. A pastor, Joseph Belcher, began a monthly publication for youth titled Mutual Instructor. Davis contributed this hymn to its pages. Well, praise God. All right, now the references here. So stanza 1, we have Philippians 3:7, Matthew 6:19, Colossians 3:1-2, and Psalm 16:11. Stanza 2, we have 1 Peter 1:6, Romans 12:12, Romans 8:18, and Psalm 31:24. In stanza 3, we have Hebrews 13:14, 1 Peter 4:12, Hebrews 4:9, and Philippians 3:14. So that is the first hymn there, and now we're going to jump over to the second hymn, which was originally going to be the first hymn. And let me go find this group of men here. So let me go back here. All right, so turn this down here. And get the ad out of the way here first. All right. So like I said before, what we're going to do is I'll read you the stanzas here. I think there's 10 of them. So all 10 stanzas, and I'll let you listen to this group of men here singing this hymn. So this is titled The Song of the Soldier, and this is another one of these, The Spiritual Warfare of the Saint Hymns, a spiritual song, and this is hymn 719 in the Psalms and Hymns and Spiritual Songs book, written by Justice Faulkner, that's Falkner, and he lived from 1672 to 1723, that's a long time ago, translated by Emma F. Bevan, that's B-E-V-A-N, Bevan, 1827 to 1909, and then James McGranahan, who lived from 1840 to 1907 for the refrain, and then again James McGranahan, 1840 to 1907. So, like I said, there's 10 stanzas here, so I'll read you all 10 of these stanzas and then the refrain. So here we go. Stanza 1 says, "Rise, ye children of salvation, all who cleave to Christ the head. Wake, arise, O mighty nation, ere the foe on Zion tread." Stanza 2, "Follow Christ and fear no evil. Trust his arm and all is well. Face to face with every devil, with the mighty host of hell." Stanza 3, "Conquerors by the blood of Jesus, fearless in our faith and prayer. He from every terror frees us, makes us strong to do and dare." Stanza 4, "Saints and heroes long before us, firmly on this ground have stood. See their banners waving o'er us, conquerors through the Savior's blood." Stanza 5, "He who loveth slavery better, slavery now and evermore. He who loves sin's galling fetter, follows not the shout of war." Stanza 6, "But the man to whom is given light to know his freedom's worth, all whose treasure is in heaven, God his all in heaven and earth." Stanza 7, he whose fetters are not riven, lives a life that is not a life, hearts but half to Jesus given, know of naught but care and strife." Stanza 8, "Therefore we will fight victorious by the blood of Christ our Lord. On our foreheads bright and glorious shines the witness of his word." Stanza 9, "Deathless we are all unfearing, life laid up with Christ and God. In the morn of his appearing floweth forth a glory flood." Stanza 10, "When his servants stand before him, each receiving his reward, when his saints in light adore him, giving glory to the Lord." And then the refrain goes like this. It says, "Pour it forth a mighty anthem, pour it forth a mighty anthem." And then on top it says, "Pour it forth a mighty anthem, like the thunders of the sea, like the thunders of the sea, through the blood of Christ our ransom, through the blood of Christ our ransom. On the bottom, it says, "More than conquerors are we, more than conquerors are we." And then the bottom continues like that. And it says, "More than conquerors are we, conquerors are we, through the blood of Christ our ransom, more than conquerors are we. Amen." So that is the hymn there, and I'll give you the references really quick. No story for this one, and then we'll listen to these men that are singing it here. So stanza 1, we have Colossians 1:18 and Romans 13:11. Stanza 2, we have 2 Timothy 1:7 and 1 Peter 5:8. Stanza 3 is Romans 8:37 and Ephesians 6:10. Stanza 4 is Hebrews 12:1. And Hebrews 11, the whole entire chapter. And then stanza 5 is Romans 6:16 and Galatians 5:7. Stanza 6 is Galatians 5:1 and Matthew 6:21. Stanza 7 is Romans 6:12 and 1 Corinthians 3:3. And then stanza 8 is 1 Timothy 6:12 and 2 Peter 1:19. Stanza 9 is Colossians 3:3 and Colossians 3:4. And then stanza 10 is 1 Corinthians 3:8-15 and Revelation 5:9-10. And then for the refrain, we have Mark 10:45, Romans 8:37, and 2 Corinthians 2:14. So now let's go ahead and I'll let you listen to these men here. And the name of this group is the, it says here they're titled, Exclusively Voice, and it's titled The Hymns. I guess that's the name of their album. And so I guess if you want me to send this to you, you can request it or look it up by typing in Song of the Soldier and look them up that way. So here we go.
Rise, ye children of salvation, all who cleave to Christ the head. Wake, arise, O mighty nation, hear the foe on Zion's tread. Pour it forth, a mighty anthem, pour it forth. The mighty anthem, like the thunders of the sea, through the blood of Christ our ransom. More than conquerors are we, more than conquerors are we, more than conquerors are we, through the blood of Christ our ransom. More than conquerors are we. Saints and heroes long before us, firmly on this ground have stood. See their banners waving o'er us, conquerors through Jesus' blood. Pour it forth, a mighty anthem, pour it forth.
I like that part.
The mighty anthem, like the thunders of the sea, through the blood of Christ our ransom. More than conquerors are we.
Hallelujah.
More than conquerors are we. More than conquerors are we. Through the blood of Christ our ransom.
Praise the Lord. All right, well, they only did two of the stanzas there. They did the first stanza, and then they did the, I think it was the fourth stanza. So, but you get an idea of what it sounds like, and then the refrain there, I really like the refrain, how they're like, we are more than conquerors. It's like a marching type of anthem there, so, amen. That's a good one. And wish they would have sang the whole thing, but you get the idea of what it sounds like. And then the refrain is really kind of neat how they did that. So, all right, so that's the hymns for today. And then the group there, again, the name of the group, I think it's, Exclusively Voice. It's, this is how they spell it. It's X-C-L-U-S-I, or Exclusive Voice, so it's X-C-L-U-S-I-V, Voice is how they spell that, Exclusive, so, and sure they have other hymns there that they sing. Alright, so that's that, and now let's go ahead and, before we get into, we'll actually go do the scripture songs again, then we'll do these prayer cards, so got a bunch of them today, and these are all prayer cards we've had done before in the past, but in case you didn't get their information, we'll give it again today. And so we'll do the scripture song singing first, and then do the prayer cards afterwards, and then wrap it up after that. So, all right. We are more than conquerors. I like that. That's it. Okay, so let's go back to the 21st, so yesterday, and do that one here. So Ecclesiastes 3:14.
Ecclesiastes 3:14.
I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. And God doeth it that men should fear before him. I like that part. I know that whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. Nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. And God doeth it that men should fear before him. God doeth it that men should fear before him. It shall be forever. Whatsoever God doeth, it shall be forever. nothing can be put to it, nor anything taken from it. God doeth it that men should fear before him. God doeth it that men should fear before him. It shall be forever. It shall be forever. Forever. All right, now today's again another good one. I like this one.
Isaiah 43.
Gets a little faster each time, like I was explaining.
Even everyone that is
beginning.
Called by my name, for I have created him. For my glory, I have
formed right.
him. Yea, I have made him.
All right, here we go.
And everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory.
I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name, even everyone that is called by my name, for I have created him for my glory. I have formed him, yea, I have made him. Even everyone that is called by my name. Amen. All right. So that's the end of the scripture songs. And again, in the middle of the page here, this is what it looks like there on the page. And it says, the Bible will keep you from sin, or sin will keep you from the Bible. So, all right, now let's go ahead and do these prayer cards here, and we'll start with Brother Miles Mayer, and he just got married recently, so it's him and his wife doing the ministry now, and this is his prayer card. This is the old one, so he doesn't have her on the prayer card yet, but this is what his prayer card looks like, the front of it, and so that's him there, Brother Mayer, and then the back of it, you can take a screenshot there and flip it around and keep it in your archives there if you want to keep these prayer cards there for you. And this says here, Miles Mayer, and it says, reaching the world one ship at a time. That's right. And this is where he's stationed at, ministering to the seafarers from around the world in the port of Mobile, Alabama. And here's his information, Miles Mayer. And his phone number is 850-712-6830. And then we have milesmayer721 at gmail.com. And I'll spell that out for you. That's MYLESMAHER721 at gmail.com to get a hold of him. And then the sending church is Ridge Road Baptist Church in Brewton, Alabama. And then the mailing address is 3600 Ridge Road, Brewton, Alabama, 36426. And Brewton is B-R-E-W-T-O-N. So that's the information for Brother Mayer. So put that there. And then next we have the Siramack family. And so this is their prayer card. I believe this is the newest one for them. I have so many of them, but this is the newest one, I believe. So that's the front of it, if you want to take a screenshot there. Sorry about the glare, trying to get that out of there for you. So that's the front, and then the back of the prayer card. I'll try to get that there for you without the glare. So that's the back of it, and this is the Siramack family, and they got all their names there, the family, and they're in Papua New Guinea, missionaries to Papua New Guinea. And this is their information on the back of the prayer card. Contact info is P.O. Box 1194, Mount Hagen. That's H-A-G-E-N, Hagen, W-H-P, comma, P-N-G. That's the initials for Papua New Guinea there. And then we have Kenneth Siramack at gmail.com is the email address. And then 843-489-7790 is the phone number. And then we have SiramackFamilyPNG.com. Support address is WFTWBM, P.O. Box 849, Rossville, Georgia, 30741. And then that number is 706-866-8826. And then that is WFTWBM.org. And then their sending church is Calvary Baptist Church, Pastor Manny Rodriguez, and that's 256 Old Savannah Highway, Beaufort, South Carolina, 29906. 843-525-1133 is the phone number, and then that's calvarybaptistbeaufort.com. Beaufort is spelled B-E-A-U-F-O-R-T, so that's the website there for them. So that's their information. And then we got Blake and Muscat and little Sabina. She's not on this prayer card. This is her old one before they had her. So this is their prayer card there. And all they were visiting this weekend, along with Brother Mayer was here for the youth rally. And so they were here also, Brother Blake and Sister Haley and little Sabina. So that was their, that's their prayer card there. And then the back of it, there is the back of the prayer card. And this is Blake and Haley Muscat, Lifeline Baptist Seamen Ministry. And the back of the card says, reaching every nation, one ship at a time. And then the contact info is ibsmvirginia@gmail.com. And then the number is 352-299-4461. And then their sending church, of course, is Bible Baptist Church, 872 Glenwood Road, DeLand, Florida, 32720. And then for ministry updates, you can go to ibsmvirginia.com. So that's Brother Blake and Sister Haley Muscat's information. And then we have the Back family. They're getting ready to go to Papua New Guinea to be missionaries over there with the Siermax. So they're leaving on the 30th, I believe, is their last day here, flying there. And they got their visas and everything all set and ready to go. And so they're ready to fly out of here and get over there. We'll miss them at Bible Baptist. And maybe you know them or don't know them yet, but this is their prayer card. And sorry about the glare there. That's their prayer card there and the front there. And then the back, this is the back cover there. Trying to get as close as possible without the glare. So you can take a snapshot of that, and hopefully that's clear for you. So this is the Back family, missionaries of Papua New Guinea. And the back of their prayer card says the Back family, and then it gives their names of their family there. And then their contact information is 904-860-6412. And then it's jscottback@gmail.com. And so that's their email address. And then the support address is Word for the World, P.O. Box 849, Rossville, Georgia, 30741. And then that phone number is 706-866-8826. And of course, their sending church is the same as the Muscat's, Bible Baptist Church at 872 Glenwood Road, DeLand, Florida, 32720, 386-736-9274. So that's their information, the Back family. And then finally, the last one here is the Kerwins. And it was a very emotional night last night as we were saying goodbye to them. They're traveling to rural Nebraska today. They're heading there to be missionaries there and to get the word of God out over there in rural Nebraska. And this is their prayer card there, the Kerwins, Brother Gage and Sister Lauren and their children. So there's the front of their prayer card there. And then the back of it here, and it's got the little QR code that you can scan there. And that's the back of their prayer card. And this is Gage and Lauren, and then their two children. And they're going to be serving in rural Nebraska. And the back of the prayer card says the state of Nebraska. It says here, Matthew 9:37-38, says the harvest truly is plenteous, but the laborers are few. Pray ye therefore the Lord of the harvest, that he will send forth laborers into his harvest. And then the sending church, of course, is Bible Baptist Church again. And Brother James is our pastor. And then jameswknox.org is the church website, which I'll give you that again here in a few minutes. And then their mailing address is 48332 Highway 12, Butte, Nebraska. And that's spelled B-U-T-T-E, Butte, Nebraska, 68722. And then for more information about us or our mission, scan the QR code or visit our website at outlawtrailministries.com. So that's their information, so pray for them. And they are traveling up there today. And then also pray for Brother Blake and Sister Haley and their family and all those that are traveling back today and that were traveling back this weekend, that they make it all back safely. All those youth groups that came and were there for the youth rally, and for Brother Alltop also and his family and ministry and up there in Kentucky. So, amen. All right, so those are the prayer cards for today that you can pray for them. And then also, let me grab this one here really quick and have you pray for them too, because they're getting ready to have a baby, and they are at staying by this hospital there just in case she has it here soon. So the Jensens, Jacob and Kirsten Jensen, also pray for them. And they're missionaries to the Navajo Nation. So that's their prayer card there. So you can pray for them also. And pray for good health with the baby and when it's delivered and all that. And it's Lord will protect them and all that. So that's where they're from. Jacob and Kirsten Jensen, missionaries to Navajo Nation there. So, and then the back here has the information. The phone number is 763-337-3785. And then that's jensens2az@gmail.com. And then www.navajolandbaptistmissions.com is the website there. And, of course, their sending church is Bible Baptist Church also. And then, so that's that. And then the support address is Bible Baptist Church. And then you can put in attention Jensen Support. So that's them. All right. So extra one for you. Okay. So put that aside now so you have those to pray for. And so that's that. And now let's go ahead and give you tomorrow's topic for the Baptist Spread and the Daily Strength books. And then the scripture song for tomorrow, and then the hymns. So tomorrow will be Tuesday, April 23rd, and it's titled This Old House. We have Luke 6:49 as the passage, and the author tomorrow is Brother Tim Green from Revival in Our Times, Day Heights, Ohio. So he's the one that wrote tomorrow's topic there. And then we have tomorrow's scripture song is from 1 Peter 5:8, and it says here, be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, as a roaring lion, walketh about seeking whom he may devour. And that's the truth. So we got to be vigilant and watching and praying at all times and all that. So that's the scripture song tomorrow. And then the topic for the Daily Strength book, as we're continuing on this week on fasting, is titled Fasting Not Optional. And this is Day 80, Tuesday. And Matthew 6:16 is the passage here, and we'll go over that tomorrow. And then the hymn for tomorrow is titled Trust and Obey, and that's a good hymn. So that'll be the second hymn for tomorrow. I might make it the first hymn, depending on which one we have here in the book. So let's flip over to tomorrow. And the first hymn will be titled The Banner of the Cross, another good one. And this is another one of these, a spiritual warfare of the saint hymns, a spiritual song. And this is hymn 720. We've already reached hymn 720, and we still got this left here. But praise the Lord for all these hymns, many we know and many we don't know yet, but we'll know them together as we sing them and find the instrumental for these. Most of them have instrumentals, some of them don't. So, all right, so that's tomorrow's hymn, and there is a story for this one. And so, praise the Lord. See, Daniel W. Whittle is the hymn writer, and then it's he's writing as L. Nathan, and then James McGranahan again for tomorrow's hymn. So, all right, so that's the first hymn there. And what did I do with the bookmarker here? Right, put that there. And so this is the cover of the hymn book. This is the blue color. There's three different colors to this hymn book here. The blue one, this dark blue one, and then there's also a brown cover, and then there's another bluish, grayish cover of the hymn book there, and then there's a leather-bound edition of the hymn book there, and so that's that book. And then the Daily Strength Volume 2 book, there's four series of books here in these devotionals, four volumes there, and all those books can be found at melodypublications.com is the website there, and that's where you can get all those books and other materials. And then the Scripture Song book and CDs, they are available online, or you can contact Brother Dean to find out how to get the CDs. Not sure how to get them these days, but you can contact him about that. And that website is www.dailyscripturesongs.com, and they are missionaries to Port Kaituma, Guyana, so pray for them and Brother Dean's health. And it sounds like in the prayer letter that there's really nothing else that the doctors will do or want to do as far as surgery or transplants or anything like that. So just basically he's going to have to deal with the pain while he's here on this earth. So pray the Lord will continue to use him in a mighty way wherever he's having to stay at. And right now it's here in Florida. And I believe that Sister Patty is going to be getting ready for VBS coming up here in a few months. And then Brother Blake and Sister Haley and their little girl will be traveling to Guyana with a group of 10, I believe, and going there and helping with the VBS work there this summer. So pray for all that, and that the mission work continues there, and brothers and sisters over there that live there locally have taken over the work in the meantime. So pray for all that, and that's how you can get these items here. And so you can read their prayer letter on the website. I'm sure they have it posted up there or on the Facebook page if you're friends with them on Facebook. So there's that. And then the Baptist Bread devotional book. This is from last month and this month. So if you order now, you'll get the one for May and June. And it comes in a box of 10, and it's $12.95. Every other month, you'll get a box of these. And it's and so you can keep one for yourself and hand the other ones out. And that's baptistbread.com. or www.timgreenministries.org are the websites there. And then that second website has other books available to order. If you go on that website to check out those books there, I'm not sure which books are up there, but many good ones, sure. So, all right, so that's that. And then the Bible, the King James Bible, the Word of God. This is the first book we should always be getting into and reading it and studying it and showing thyself approved unto God, a workman that needeth not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth, and going to God in prayer and seeking his face, asking him to guide you and direct you in all truth and show you how to know who he's talking to and how we can apply it to ourselves in different ways, like practical ways and spiritual ways, and what's being written to us in the New Testament and as born-again believers in Christ. And if you're not saved, you need to get saved first and then go from there. So that's the King James Bible, the Word of God. And then also the other broadcast I do that I like to mention that I do so you can watch that broadcast is where I've been reading Brother James's book on Genesis, part of the Christ Honoring Commentary series. And that book is not in print right now, but you can find his other books that are still in print at the present time at www.jameswknox.org, or go straight to the store part of the website, which is store.jameswknox.org, and look up all the books there. And then if you want to listen to any of his sermons, got a lot of good ones from past and present. And you can also go to the YouTube channel, which is James Knox Sermons YouTube channel, where you can look up all his sermons that way. Video versions of the messages there. All right. And then also one more thing is the podcast that I do. That's God's Messenger Lighthouse podcast, and that's on Spotify or iHeartRadio, where I read different heroes of the Christian faith and missionary stories. And working through this book on Eric Liddell, which is by YWAM Publishing Company and written by Jeff and Janet Benge. So check that out. And then if you want to look me up, if you don't have Facebook or know somebody that doesn't have Facebook and want to look me up on the YouTube channel, that's Ambassador for Christ Broadcasting, or typing in Baptist Bread Broadcast and look me up that way and like and subscribe and hit that notification bell so you know when I'm posting those up on the YouTube channel. So, all right, well, that'll be about it for today. So thanks for watching, and may the Lord richly bless you until next time. Bye-bye for now.